邀请我们陈牧师来为我们讲。
So that's it for our announcements. Let's give a round of applause for Pastor Andrew as we invite him to come and speak.
Thank you, everyone. Hallelujah. All right. Okay. 今天我要继续 together the message.
Today I want to continue this message about togetherness.
告诉你旁边的人 ，together is better.
Tell your neighbor, together is better. 一起更好。
Amen. Together, it's better.
一起更好。
不但是 better, we got it together in love. Amen. 在爱里面来在一起。Hallelujah. 所以告诉你旁边的人，你看起来比上个礼拜可爱一些。
So tell your neighbor, say, you are cuter today, you are better looking today than you were last week.
How many people you believe that 你比上个礼拜可爱一些的，有没有？
How many know that you are better this week than you were last week?
没有举手的你是怎样？你不觉得我去剪的头发比上个礼拜好看了一些吗
？Don't you feel like after I cut my hair, I look a lot cuter than last week?
我们可以更好，每一个礼拜靠着主的恩典。
We can get better and better every single week as we lean on Christ.
今天我要分享一家人在一起。
And so today I want to discuss this idea of together as a family.
Amen. 好，我们一起来看这张照片。这是几个礼拜前在后院我们有 Father's Day， 所以。这个弟兄的烤肉。
So if you take a look at this picture, you see that a couple of weeks ago during Father's Day, our men got together and had a barbecue.
我感谢主啊，New Life 有很多的弟兄 ，Hallelujah!
I thank God that in New Life we have many men here.
你知道当这些臭男生聚在一起的时候
，You know when all these, you know, how do you say 臭男生 stinky men get together.
但是我们在那里烤肉的时候，我们在那里 share 的时候，哇，这是非常的快乐。
But when we got together to barbecue, to talk and just have a good time, we were so full of joy.
因为我在主里面，我可以有这么多的好弟兄，好像是一家的人一样。
Because in Christ, we had such a family together.
尤其弟兄是特别的困难。
And especially some men who are.Usually extremely difficult.
你知道一个女人拿起电话来的话，可以讲半个小时、一个小时，甚至更久的。
You know, when women get together, they can pick up their phones and talk for hours.
但是男人通常谈话呢，两句、三句就没话讲。
But with men, it's like over the phone, two or three sentences, and later we don't have anything much to say.
有多少我们当中的弟兄觉得你的生命当中需要有更多的好弟兄可以谈话的
？And so, how many of you feel like in your life you need more good men that you can discuss life with? Yeah.We don't need the men, apparently.
其中另外一个可能就是男人喜欢躲在洞里面不出来的。
Maybe perhaps some of you guys like to hide in holes and not come out.
But anyway, 感谢主，我们有一群的弟兄一起来追寻我们的神。
But we really thank God for the men that came together to pursue God.
在我的心里面有一个负担。
In my heart, I have a passion.
教会的弟兄。一定要被神建造起来。
I want to see the men in church to rise up.
Amen. 因为男人站起来，家就稳固了。
Because when the men rise up, the family will be stable.
我再说一次，男人在主里面站起来，这个家一定稳固的。
When the men rise up in a family, the house will be stable.
当家稳固的时候，教会就会稳固。
And so when the family is strong, the church will be strong.
我们的国家。也会强盛
And so therefore, then our nation will be strong.
所以每一位弟兄，我要在这里鼓励你们，你们要为主的缘故勇敢地站起来。
And so once again, I want to declare unto you men here that you need to be courageous to stand up.
那么在座所有的姐妹，我要鼓励你们常常为弟兄们来祷告。
And so women in here, I want to encourage you constantly be praying for the men.
你不要跟他吵架。
Don't fight with them.
你不要跟他们叨叨念。
Don't nag at them.
你只要跟神讲就可以了。
Just tell to God.
神自然会处理他们。
And God will take care of that guy.
姐妹说 ，Yes. 好，我们正式进入主题。来，我们一起来读马可福音十二章三十到三十三。
Let's read Mark chapter 12, verse 30 to 33.
我们一起念来。耶稣回答说：“第一要紧的就是以色列啊，你要听主，我们神是独一的主。”你要尽心、尽性、尽意、尽力爱主你的神。哦，在这里英文圣经说，这是最重要的一个命令 ，the most important command。这是上帝给我们的命令。命令我什么吗？ 命令我们要尽心、尽性、尽意、尽力爱主你的上帝。
This commandment says that we need to, with all of our strength, with all our soul, with all our heart, all our minds, to love the Lord our God.
所以各位，当我们敬拜神的时候， are we really with all my heart, with all my strength, with all my might?
And so, brothers and sisters, when we are together to worship, are we worshiping with all of our strength?
无论我们做什么，都要尽心的去做。
No matter what it is that we do, we should do it with all that we have, yeah?
有多少人你相信用心做的事一定是最美？
How many of you know when you do things with, you know, everything that you have, it's done well?
Hallelujah. 所以在这里主给我们第一个命令。第一要紧的就是爱你的神。第二呢，我们一起来念。
So、God,
其次就是说要爱人如己，再没有比这更大诫命更大了。
Wow. So God gives us a second commandment, and He says equally as important, love your neighbor as yourself.
所以不但爱神，也同时爱我们周围的人。
And so not only to love God, but to love those around you.
So this is why 十字架是这样子的。
And so this is why that we see the cross is in such a shape.
Vertical, 垂直的爱神, horizontal, 爱我们周围的人。
Vertically to love God, but then horizontally to love the people on the left and right.
今天我要跟各位分享的是第二个，这里提到了要爱人如己。
Now today what I want to talk about is the second command about loving your neighbors.
所以但是中文写的比较说爱人如己，很多人以为要爱自己。各位 love your neighbor.
But what it says is love your neighbor.
这个邻舍包括了谁?
What does that include?
包括你的家人、你的邻居、包括你上班的同事、包括那些经常在你身边出现的人。
These people include your family members, your neighbors, and your colleagues at work, and also any person that is often appearing by your side in your life.
所以现在坐在你旁边的人就是你的邻舍。
And so that person sitting next to you right now is the one that you are called to love.
Hallelujah. 看着笑着对他说，主说要我爱你。
So smile to the person next to you and tell them, God wants me to love you.
Amen. That's important. Love your neighbor.所以中国有一个诗人讲了这样的一句话，他说：“落地成兄弟，何必亲骨肉。”
So, there's a saying that says, "If you are a brother, why bother with your own flesh and blood?"
其实不一定是要爱在你有血缘关系的。
And so you don't really need to love those who are, you know, blood related to you.
各位，我每个礼拜跟你们在一起的时间，比我跟我弟弟妹妹的时间还多。
What I'm saying is, you could love people by your side as a brother, because I spend more time with some of you guys than those of my family.
这个疫情已经快一年半了，我一年半没有机会跟他们相处在一起。
It's been a year and a half that this pandemic has, you know, been with us, and so this year and a half, I've not had a chance to go back to Taiwan and see my family.
但这一年的里面，这一年多的里面，我差不多每个礼拜都可以看到 Sherman 一起去爬山。
But this year and a half, every single week, I see my brother Sherman from church, and I'm always with him hiking.
所以我感觉我跟他应该比我弟弟还亲才对。
So I feel like now I'm more intimate with Sherman than I am with my brother.
I want to say in this way, Sherman is my brother.
But I want to declare, Sherman 是我的弟弟。
要拍手就拍大力，不要害怕人家。你拍的是对的，他们不拍是错的。弟兄姐妹，你旁边的人就是你的邻舍。
The person next to you is your brother.
为什么在教会里面我们不称先生女士，我们称弟兄和姐妹 ？Because we are one family.
Why is it in the church that we don't call one another, oh, this man or this woman? We say this brother or this sister because we are one family.
We are family, right?各位，我们的确是一家的人。
The truth is, we are one family.
Amen. Hallelujah. 我一直看着 Ryan, he's my younger son. Hallelujah.
I see Ryan, and he's like my son.
因为他现在住在我家。Hallelujah.
And he now lives at my house.
We are family.
我们是一家人。
Good.为什么我们是一家人？
Why are we one family?
一起来读这段圣经。这样，如果我行其言误，你也可以知道在上帝的家中应该怎么做。这家是永活上帝的教会，是真理的柱石和根基。所以这里告诉我们说，这里是告诉我们 It's the house of God.
And so here the scripture says that it is in the house of God which the church is living.
Amen. 教会是永生神的家。
This is a place where the living God lives in this house.
弟兄姐妹，我们不是去教会，我们是一起进入神的家。
We are not going to church. We are going to God's house.
Amen. 那么有多少你相信在这个教会里面 in New Life, how many people you recognize you are family, the member of family?
How many of you here today, 你在这里谁觉得说你就是在这里的一家人的一个 member?
Amen. 有很多人来教会是来当客人。
A lot of people come to church to come as a guest.
从来不把教会当成他的家。
They don't make the church their home.
我在这里不管包括线上 Arcadia, Rancho Cucamonga 的弟兄姐妹，牧师要鼓励你，你要把你自己的教会当成家。
Including those that are in Rancho Cucamonga and Arcadia, I want to encourage you, make the church your home.
Amen.既然是家，就是家人，而不是客人。
Since it is a home, then we are family members, not guests.
既然是家人，就要一起来做家事。
And since we are family members, then we ought to do the family chores.
所以看到什么需要，就卷起袖子来，就来做家事。
And so if you see anything that has need, come on, roll up your sleeves and let's work on it together.
我发现在北美有一个非常严重的现象，就是很多的基督徒到处去做客人。
I've seen something that is happening in America is that often many Christians go from church to church to be guests of different churches.
包括现在在线上的弟兄姐妹，牧师鼓励你要一起做家人。
I want to encourage you, even if you're watching from online, to be part of the family.
如果你还没有找到一个教会成为你的家，我们欢迎你。
If you haven't found a church that you can call home, then we invite you that you can make this your home.
但如果你说牧师，我找不到任何一个教会可以成为我的家。
Now, if you might be saying, "Well, Pastor, I have a hard time finding a church to make home."
啊，你可以让我知道。
You can let me know.
And I will help you.
我会帮助你。
所以各位，既然在家里面，大家就一起来参与建造神荣耀的教会。
And so, since we are here together as a family, then let us together build up God's house.
所以我要鼓励各位，家庭在上帝的心里面是非常的重要。
Family is so important in God's heart.
因为三位一体的神就在一个 family, 一个 Father, Son, and Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
If you see the Trinity, you'll see that they are a family.Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
是上帝创造的人。
And so when God created man,
上帝创造的婚姻。
God created marriage,
上帝创造的家庭。
God created family.
但是家庭却是撒旦要摧毁的目标。
But the devil wants to destroy the family. That is his goal.
所以撒旦想尽各样的办法要破坏现今的家庭。
So he's looked to different ways that he can destroy families.
所以各位，我要说，家庭在撒旦的里面是一个 target， 是一个靶心。
So there's a target in the enemy and the devil.
他只要能够摧毁家庭，他就能够摧毁这个国家。
If he can destroy the family, he can destroy a nation.
所以我要鼓励每一个弟兄或者是姐妹，一定要勇敢地站立起来，为我们的家站立。
So I want to encourage you, brothers and sisters, to stand up together to fight for your family.
尼希米记第四章甚至提醒我们，做弟兄的要为你的家征战。
And Nehemiah says that he decrees to the men of the people of God that they will stand up to fight for their families.
今天魔鬼破坏这个世界，破坏很多的家庭。
The devil has destroyed so many families in this season, this day and age.
各位，你可以看到这几个人。我想你看到这个图片，有多少人你认识上面这三个？不是，你知道这三个
？If you look on this picture today, do you know who these three people are?
Amazon 的创办人 Jeff Bezos.
Amazon CEO Jeff Bezos.
Microsoft 的创办人 Bill Gates.
The pioneer of Microsoft, Bill Gates.
Tesla 的创办人 Elon Musk.
The founder of Tesla, Elon Musk.
他们都有非常好的成就。
They all have so much success.
Amazon 的创办人 Jeff Bezos, 他现在是全世界的首富。
And Jeff Bezos, the Amazon founder, he is the
number one.
The number one in the world.
他是最有钱的人。这个世界最有钱的人。
He has the most money in the world.
2019年他离婚。
In 2019, he had a divorce.
哇，他的离婚的手续，他的离婚分给他的太太是$660 million.
And so, in the divorce, how much did he have to give up to his wife? A lot.
被称为全世界最贵的离婚。
It became the most expensive divorce in all the world.
我一看到这个数字，我就不敢离婚。
When I see this statistic, I do not dare to divorce.
我根本付不起啊。
I can't pay for that.
所以我就继续忍受 no, 不对不对，享受对。
And so I continue to press on. I'm just kidding. I continue to enjoy my marriage.
中间的 Microsoft Bill Gates 就在今年五月份离婚。
And Bill Gates, in May of this year, divorced as well.
Bill Gates 跟他的太太结婚29年分开。
And in 29 years of being together this year, the news came out that Bill Gates
他成功的创办了 Microsoft.
He was the one that designed Microsoft.
第三个 Tesla, Elon Musk.
Thirdly, Elon Musk.
他离婚了两次。
He's divorced twice.
我想我在这里不是在讲他们的不好。
Now, I'm not here to speak badly of these men.
They have a great achievement.
他们有很多的
成就。
成就。
But they are never successful. 但他们从来没有成功过。一个人要成功，必须成功在他的家里面。
Somebody who wants to be successful,
一个人成功
needs to be
必须成功在他的家里面。
You need to be successful in your family first.
Amen.这三个人，其中有两个曾经成为这个世界最有钱的人 ，Tesla 现在排第二。
These three men were some of the most powerful men, Tesla being the second.
各位，我可以很清楚的看到魔鬼，撒旦用各样的方法。要破坏神所设立的婚姻跟家庭。
So through this, I can see that the enemy is.Very seriously targeting marriages and families to destroy family in the people.
成就跟财富并不代表所有的一切。
And so success and achievement does not represent all things.
Hallelujah. 所以我们必须知道什么才是真正重要的。
So we need to remember what is really important.
现在的家庭的 definition, 家庭的定义是很混乱的。
The definition of family has become very confusing.
有个叫做核心家庭，有个单亲家庭，有个叫混合家的 blended family， 还有一种叫做同性家庭。现在台湾很流行多元家庭。
There's all these different terms that you could identify what a family is, and they're all just this and that really weird.
我们现在已经搞不清楚什么叫做家庭。
The truth is, nobody really understands what is a family today.
这个世界正在改变我们对家庭的观念。
The world is trying to change our understanding what family is.
Amen. 所以我要说，我鼓励在座的每个弟兄姐妹，包括在线上的弟兄姐妹，如果你的工作事业要做得好。首先先把你的家顾好。
So I want to encourage you, those online, anyone that's here, that if you want to be successful in your career, please take care of your family well first.
事业这么好的成就，最后家落的这种光景，又得到了什么呢？
If you have so much success in the marketplace, in the business world, but you have no success in your family, then what do you have?
耶稣说，人赚了全世界，赔了自己的生命，又有什么益处呢？
If you earn the whole world but you lose your life, then what is the point?
所以各位，把你的家搞好，世界就会变得更美好。Amen.
And so if you take good care of your family and do that well, then the world will be a better place.
我是在对我自己说的。
I'm telling myself.
把我的家先搞好。
Take care of my family.
就会变得更美好。
And this world will become a better place.
各位。其实一个人白天去上班，早上九点到下午五点下班。其实真正一个人在公司里面决定的是他下午以后到隔天早上八点这段时间发生什么事在他的家里面。
And so somebody who goes to work, maybe from 9 to 5, you have this time from 5 till the next morning that you have to decide what you will do with this time.
我告诉你，如果你回家下了班以后回家跟太太大吵一架，明天早上你要去上班的时候心情就是很不好。
And so if you come home from work and during that evening time you fight a great fight with your spouse, then the next day you've already decided that your day will start off very aggressive and rough.
所以我礼拜六晚上一定要对师母比较好一点，要不然
礼
拜天就很难。
On Saturday nights, I have to be very careful how I treat my wife so that the next day.
有多少曾经带敬拜的人跟我讲，牧师不知道为什么礼拜六就是征战很大。
And there's a lot of worship leaders who have told me, you know, it's so weird that on Saturdays the conflicts, the battle, is always so difficult.
明天我就是要带敬拜，平常都没事，但是礼拜六今天都发生特别多的事情。
I know that I have to lead worship on Sunday. Normally we have a good time at home in our families, but just so happens every Saturday.Something has to have a conflict.
把自己的家搞好了，世界就变得更美好了。
If you take good care of your family, once again, I say the world will be a better place.
我要再说，我们把我们的家弄好，其实就是对下一代最大的见证。
And also, if we take good care of our families, it is really the greatest testimony that we can give to our next generation.
我们把我们的家弄好，也是让我们的孩子知道我们的神是帮助我们的神。
And if we take good care of our families, we know that we're telling our families in the next generation that there is a God who is taking care of us.
这个礼拜五我参加了 Arcadia 的一个小组。
This week I joined a cell group out in Arcadia.
感谢主，那个小组的来的人几乎差不多95%。都是 couple 的。
Praise God that this cell group, there was about 95% of the group that was all couples.
然后另外一个小组的小组长也被邀请来。
And then there was another cell leader that was invited to come and join this meeting.
他就忽然间看到整个小组里面这个小组的每一个人每一个来的都是一对一对的。
Because he saw that the whole group was full of couples.
他说牧师。我这个也是 single， 我那个也是 single， 这个都全部都是 single。
And then the cell leader said, "Well, every single person that I have is single, single, single."
他们 single 的原因是因为他们的家庭破碎。
And the reason why they're singles is because their families had broken apart.
他说我们全组里面就我一个人是夫妻的。
And this whole group, the only person was the cell leader that was still a couple.
所以我就告诉他，我说。因为神知道你有这个怜悯的心，所以神把这些人全部送到你的小组里面。
And so I said to her or him that you know, God knows you have a compassionate heart, and so because of your compassion, God is sending these people to you.
家庭正在面对很大的挑战。
There's a great challenge against the family in the season.
我相信有一天，这一个 Amazon 的老板到了上帝那里，我希望他能够上去。对。
I believe one day that.If Amazon's founder could go to God,
上帝不会跟他讲 ，Wow, Bezos, you did a good job. 你做得太好。你在地上的年日创办了 Amazon.
I don't think God would say, "Oh, good job, Jeff Bezos. You've created so many things through Amazon."
上帝不会跟 Bill Gates 说，哇，你超聪明的，你创办了 Microsoft.
I don't think God would say, "Wow, your great, you know, intellect has created so many great Microsoft products."
各位，这一些东西都会过去。
All of these things will pass.
将来我们站在神的面前的时候，我们要怎么回应神
？But when we stand before God, how will we be accountable to God?
So family is a mission critical. Amen. 家庭非常非常的重要。不单是我们肉身的家庭，包括我们属灵的家庭。
Not only in our physical families, but even in our spiritual families.
各位，我今天早上跟你们分享这个信息，并不代表我做得很好。
Now, me sharing this today doesn't mean that I've done it perfectly.
我尽力的、努力的带好我的家。
I've done what I can to you know, with every effort that I can to try to take and lead my family.
我也曾经经历过很艰难的时段。
But I've also been through a lot of very difficult times.But I praise God that God gave me the strength to endure.
上帝也把另外一个家庭，就是他的教会，也托付给我。
Also, God gave me another family, which is the family of the church.
我们也经过很多的挑战。
And we've also been through many challenges.
但是直到今天，我还站在这里。
But to this day, our family is still here together.
Because I fight for this family.
Because we fight for this
family. I fight for new life, this family. Amen. No matter what, I will not give up.
我不会放弃的。
我站在这里并不代表我是哇婚姻美满家庭的专家。No, not at all.
When I stand here, I'm not trying to speak from some sort of professional family coach.
I did not say I'm coach. All right. 我承认结婚38年到今天我还在奋斗当中。
And so even though I've been married for 38 years and yet still I'm going through it.
我还在这个 process 里面。
I'm in that journey of process.
其实这38年跌跌撞撞的走到今天。
I've fallen and gotten up through many times to get to today.
有时候在高山，有时候在低谷。
Sometimes I'm at the peaks of my life and sometimes I'm in those dark valleys.
我努力的把我的家变成游乐园而不是战场。I try very hard to make my house become a playground, it's not a battleground. 所以各位It's not easy to build a home. Amen. 不容易，但是求神给我们恩典。所以我要很快的跟各位看，一个健康的家庭有四个很重要的东西。
So I want to let everybody see what is a healthy family. What are these things?
这个注意，我在讲的不单是我们的家，也包括教会这个属灵的家。
And so not only for our personal families, but also for our spiritual family.
第一，上帝必须是首位。
First, families are built on a good spiritual foundation
Amen.
of God.
很多人家里面都挂了一个牌子，基督是我家之主。
A lot of people hang this plaque that the Lord is the Lord of this house.
弟兄姐妹，我要说，你不要光挂了一个牌子，但是根本一点意义都没有。
Don't just hang this plaque, but have no intention to honor it.
我们的家真的是耶稣做主吗？
Is Jesus really the Lord of your house?
我曾经探访过一个人，夫妻吵架的时候，我去他们家去探访他们。
I once visited a family that every time I went to go visit their conflicts.
结果发现，他们家原来挂着两个“基督是我家之主”的牌子都不见了。
I found that both of their plaques that says Jesus is the Lord of our house was all taken down.
我说这两个牌子去哪里了？
I said, "What happened to these plaques?"
他说牧师吵架的时候我做主。
He said, when we're in conflicts and we're fighting, I am the Lord of this house.
我的问题是，我们的家真的是上帝做主吗？
Is our family really the Lord of the house?
好，我们一起来看。
Is Jesus really the Lord of our families?
为什么上帝做主是这么重要？
Why is it important to make Jesus the Lord of our house?
一起来念。若不是耶和华建造房屋，建造的工作都是徒劳；若不是耶和华保护城池，守城者保持警觉也是徒然。
Psalm 127 says, "Unless the Lord builds the house, the builders labor in vain."
所以各位，建造我们的家是神，不是我们自己。
So the one that builds our house is really God, not ourselves.
若是我们把神摆在第一位，我告诉你，那个次序对的，所有的事情自然就对。
If we place God first in our lives, we will see that when we have the right orientation of order in life, then we will see that everything will go smoothly.
弟兄姐妹，我不要你只是把它当成一个宗教的来看。各位，我要再次的说，家庭的次序对了，整个家就对了。
I don't want to make this a religious principle. Let's just make it simple. When your life is set right as a family, then everything will be well.
如果你是一个真正相信耶稣基督的人，上帝必须在我们的家居首位。
So if you are a believer in Christ, then you need to make sure that Jesus is the true Lord of the family.
Amen. 我们来教会也是一样。
And so when we come to church, it's the same.
我们不是为小组长来的，我们不是为牧师来的，我们也不是为一些好朋友来的。
We don't come because of the cell leader. We don't come because of our friends.
今天我们坐在这里敬拜神，是因为我的心要把上帝。
We come because my heart desires to be with God.
所以各位，有曾经有一个这样的研究 ，Fuller Youth Institute， 他们曾经对300个家庭进行了35年的个案研究。
And so there was a study that was done by Fuller Youth Institute that there were 300 families that were studied for 35 years.
他们发现那些充满温馨、健康、充满爱的家庭，排行榜第一个因素居然是这个家有共同的信仰。
And what they found was the families that had warmth and love and just a safe environment was a family that had a united belief system.
所以我明白一个家庭能够稳固是他们站在信仰的根基上。
And so I truly believe that a foundation that makes a family stable is the belief in God together.
简单说就是对神的信靠。
And that belief is a belief in God.
我们必须看重对神的信心。
We have to understand the faith of believing in God.
我们必须看重每个礼拜去教会聚会的重要性。
We have to know the importance of being together as a church.
不管是崇拜，不管是儿童主日学。
Whether it's going to Sunday school or being in the main Sunday service.
不管现在在现场的或在线上的。
Whether you're online or you're here on site.
我要对一些的父母说。
I want to say to all the family, the parents.
你们必须把孩子的信仰看得很重要。
You have to see and value the faith of your children.
我们当中做父母的有没有因为孩子去学校觉得很无聊，所以妈妈爸爸就可以说，好了，你既然觉得无聊，就不要去了。
How many of you, when your kids say that, oh, you know, school is so boring, that you would tell them, okay, well, then you don't have to go to school?
我想你逼都要逼他去。
I think as a mom and dad, you would force your kids and say, no, you have to go to school. That's what you're supposed to do.
或者是你给他报名参加的游泳队或者是篮球队，他说啊，这个很无聊，我不想去，你就让他不去吗？
Or maybe, you know, you've signed them up for a basketball team or a swimming team or a music class, whatever it is, will it, because they complain that it's not that fun, that you stop them from going?
如果这些你都要他们非得要去不可，为什么去教会你变成了一种 option？
If in these things we are approached is that, no, they have to go, they have to learn these things, then why is it that at church we do not have that same attitude?
我的大儿子跟 Moses 两个人。
My oldest son and Moses.
我们从来不容许他们在礼拜天参加任何教会以外的活动。
We never allowed them, we told them that it is not okay that they would go and attend any sort of events on a Sunday.
每个主日我们都要求他们把上帝摆第一。
But instead, on Sundays, we told them that it's important to make God first and value that Sunday service.
所以有一次他就跑来， I don't want to go, I don't want to go.
So one time, you know, Moses came crying, saying, oh, I don't want to go to church.
我说问他， why don't you want to go? 你为什么不去？
I said, why don't you want to go?
他说， your preaching is so boring.
你讲道太无聊了。
You have to go.
你
就是这样，今天就是今天这样，所以可以培养出一个牧师出来。Hallelujah.
Because of this, and so today I've raised up a pastor.
所以弟兄姐妹，我要鼓励你，不要让你的孩子觉得他无聊，你就觉得说 forget it， 不然好了，你就可以做其他的事。
So don't let your kids just because they feel it's boring, so then you let them decide not to have.
弟兄姐妹，我要告诉你，你的孩子从小敬畏神，他一生要被神祝福的。
When your kids encounter God at a young age, they will have a whole life of being blessed by God.
他一生一定会被神祝福的。
An entire life of being blessed and favored by God.
Ryan 最近住在我家里面。
Ryan recently has been living in my house.
后来我才知道，他妈妈有跟师母说，不论一定要让 Ryan 去住牧师家。
It was only recently that I heard that Ryan's mom said,
因为如果他住在外面，他可能就乱搞了。
That he cannot go live anywhere else except for in pastor's home, because maybe he will go mess around if he lives anywhere else.
每一天他回来的时候，我说 ，Hey Ryan, how are you? 今天怎么样？然后我们就开始灵修了。
And so every single time Ryan comes home, we start to say, "Hey, how are you doing?" And we start to have devotional time.
我想跟 Ryan 就说，下一次看到牧师还在不在了？叮。
So maybe next time Brian comes home, he's going to look and see if I'm there and then sneak on by.
We have a very good talk.
I'm kidding.
Amen.
The truth is, whenever he comes home, we have good conversations.
And
from his life, I learned many things, and from my
life, I learned many things. Let me say again, we are family!
And I say again, 我们是一家人。
Amen. 虽然他住在台湾，但是他来的时候, just like our family, 我们的家人回到家一样。
And so even though he lives in Taiwan, but it's every time that he comes back, it's like he's back with family.
所以各位，我们必须告诉我们的孩子什么是重要的。
And so we need to remind our kids really what's important.
不管他们是小的，不管他们现在可能四十岁。
Whether your kids are little kids or they're 40-year-old kids.
Amen.
We need to remind our families what is most important in life. You might say, oh, Pastor, I don't know how to influence my kids. They just don't want to go. You absolutely can influence. As long as you don't give up.
最近我的媳妇告诉我们，告诉师母说，他们每个礼拜带孩子一起去教会聚会。
And so recently, my daughter-in-law just told me that they've been bringing their kids to church again.
我感谢主，我的孙子孙女每个都在教会里面好好的参加聚会。
I praise God that my grandsons, my granddaughters, they're all going to church and attending church every week.
其实我的媳妇以前并不是很在乎啊， she don't care this.
My daughter-in-law, she didn't really care that much about going to church. 前几天她告诉师母，她说我现在明白。 But she started to say recently how important, she started to realize how important it is that she takes her kids to church. So sometimes I take text message to my daughter-in-law. And I bless her, I pray for her. Thank God that today God is raising her back up.
Amen.
And so, brothers and sisters, I want to encourage you, do not give up.
看重彼此的信仰,
value faith in one another.
虽然有的时候他们会经过一段挣扎的时间,
and although people might be going through difficult times,
他们对信仰有很多的疑惑,
their faith might be in a lot of turmoil.
容许他们有这个过程,
but maybe it's supposed that they're supposed to go through these seasons.
不住地为他们祷告,
and so continuously pray for them.
暑假的时间，我的两个孙子每个礼拜会有两天到我们家来。
During the summertime, my two grandsons they have a chance to come to my house twice a week.
这两个 boy 就是哇，他来的时候，这就是创世纪第一章第一节，你知道吗？烟面混沌，黑暗一片。
And so when the boys come, it's like the creation of the earth in Genesis. It's like all chaotic.
所以师母就跟我讲，你不能只是跟他们玩的。And
then my wife told me, you can't just play with them all day. That's not okay.
他说你一定要跟他们灵修。
You got to spend time talking with them about the word of God.
你知道有多困难吗？
You know how hard it is?
他们坐不住三分钟的。
They can't sit for 3 minutes.
第二，他们只讲英文，中文都听不懂，我怎么跟他们灵修啊？
Secondly, they don't even speak Chinese. So how do I tell them the word of God in English?
有时候讲的时候，我看他们一脸疑惑的样子，我就知道我的英文不行。
Sometimes when I'm telling them and they're looking at me like I have no idea what you're saying, I realize, oh my goodness, my English is not so good.
但上个礼拜发生了一件事情。
Now last week something happened very remarkable.
我带着四个孩子在那边讲这个好撒玛利亚人的故事。
I was sitting with my four grandkids and I was telling them about the Good Samaritan story.
我说好撒玛利亚人，我们要做一个好撒玛利亚人，帮助那些需要的人。
And I told them we need to be like the Good Samaritan, helping others when they are in need.
讲完了以后，我就说你们觉得是不是要做一个好的人？
And I asked them afterwards, what do you think? Do you think it's good to be like the Good Samaritan?
忽然间我的大孙子 Jacob 他对我说，他说 Grandpa, 我们能够得救不是因为我们做好事。
And then my grandson, he said to me, the eldest, he said, you know, Grandpa, I realize it's not because we do good things that we can be saved.
我说 why you say it this way?
And I asked him,
你为什么这样说呢？ 他说我们得救是因为我们重生。 才可以得救，不是做好事。
And he said, wow! To me, it is because that we believe that we are saved, not because we do good things.
Little boy, 我说主啊, 我未来的孙子做牧师有盼望的, Hallelujah.
And so I said to myself, I said to God, wow, thank you, God, that as a grandfather, I have hope.
我没有教过他。
I've never taught my grandsons.
他怎么能够了解真理这么清楚？ 不是因为做好事得救， 而是因为重生得救，所以蒙得救。
But I'm amazed that my grandson, at such a young age, he would know this truth, that it is not because of the good things that we do that we are saved, but because we believe in Christ.
所以我就尽可能每一次跟他们在一起的时候， 就跟他们一起分享一段。
And so I've decided that every single time that I'm with them, I will share with them just a short scripture and talk about it. Value their faith.
Amen.
I thank God.
两个礼拜前,
2 weeks ago, I saw my mom through online.
三分钟里面,
And within 3 minutes,
她问了我好几次,
she asked me so many times,
你还在做牧师吗?
Are you still a pastor?
我说是啊，我还在做牧师啊。
I said yes, I am. I'm still pastoring.
过了几分钟以后
，couple late minutes later, she said.
她又看着我，你还在做牧师吗
？She said, are you still a pastor?
然后我母亲跟我说，我每一天都在为你祷告。
And then my mom said to me, every day I'm praying for you.
我感谢主。
I thank God,
一位祷告的妈妈。
That I have a praying mother.
Amen. I'm 62. 还好我妈妈没有问我。我妈妈没有问我，你早上起来有没有刷牙
？Thank goodness, my mom's not asking me, "Hey, did you brush your teeth this morning?"
她问的是一个最重要的问题。
But what she's asking me is very important.
你还在服侍神吗
？Are you still serving God?
各位，什么才是最重要？
Brothers and sisters, it's our lives that are most important.
第二个很快的，第一个是把神看为第一，第二家庭。
The first is to see God as first. Secondly is that we love being together as a family.
前几天我看到一句话很有意思，来大家一起用念的，大声念，不要怕。来，父亲能为孩子做最重要的事，就是爱他们的妈妈。姐妹说。
The most important thing a father can do for the children is to love their mom.
Very touched my heart.
Amen.
一个爸爸能够为孩子做最重要的事就是爱他们的妈妈。
A father's greatest act is to love the mom for their children.
很多年前我们住在 Newport 的时候。
Many years ago, when I was living out in the Newport house,
那个时候是我老大最混乱的时候。
There was a time when my eldest son was in this most rebellious stage.
我们差不多因为他的缘故剩下半条命。
We almost because of him, we were left with a lot of problems.
然后后来我跟师母决定我们要搬离开那个地方，因为我们觉得不想让他继续留在家里面，鼓励他要自己独立。
And so we decided that we as a family we were going to move and that we would not allow our son to live with us anymore.
所以那天他要搬出去的时候。
So the day that he had to move out.
因为我们也正在要搬走。
Because we were about to move out ourselves.
我跟师母我们就决定租的一个房间，只有一个房间的就是我们两个人。You have no space here.
So we decided, me and my wife, to go rent just a room in someone's house, so there was no space for my eldest son.
所以有时候做父母的真的是要用到很大的心思，对吧？
So sometimes as a parent, we have to do some very difficult things.
所以他知道爸爸妈妈现在搬到只有一个。一个房间连客厅都没有，只有一个房，跟人家分租一个房间。
And so as a son, he saw that mom and dad had to go and live in such a small little habitat, with only one room.
所以他就知道他必须出去了。
And so he realized, all right, it's time for me to leave.
当他要搬出去的时候，他跑到我的面前来跟我讲说：“爸爸，谢谢你让我住在你家26年的时间。”
And so before he moved out, he came to me and said, "Thank you, Dad, for letting me live in your house for 26 years."
但是在我搬出去之前，你可不可以答应我三件事情
？But before I move out, can you promise me three things?
我心里面想要搬就赶快走了，还有条件。
And I thought to myself, man, you still have conditions that you want to ask of me. Just move out already.
他说你要答应我，我才搬。
He said, you only if you promise me, then I will move.
我说那你就讲吧。
I said, all right, then you say.
他说第一个问题，第一个
first,
我希望你答应我的。
I wish you would promise me.
就是不管有多困难
，No matter how difficult life is,
不要放弃做。牧师的工作
Never, never, ever give up being a pastor.
哇，我心里面想，还真属灵呢。
And I thought to myself, wow, he's so spiritual.
我说好，我答应你。
I said, all right, I promise.
然后第二个
Secondly,
他说，你先答应我。
He said, you have to first promise me first.
我说你不讲，我怎么答应你
？I said, how do I promise you if you didn't say anything yet?
然后我就看见他的眼眶就流泪。
And I could see tears in his eyes.
他说：“爸爸，我在家里面跟妈妈是最杠的，最会 argue 的。
You know, me and mom, we always conflict. We always fight at home.
但是我搬出去，我搬出去之后
，But after I move out,
你答应我一件事
，You promise me one thing.
不管发生什么事情
，No matter what happens,
你一定要爱我妈妈。
You gotta love my mom.
And that made me cry.”我说 OK, I promise you. I would love you, mom.
我就说我答应你，我会爱你妈妈。
直到我前几天看到这段话的时候，我才明白， 父亲能为孩子最重要的事就是爱他们的妈妈。
It wasn't until after a couple days ago that I saw this and I realized, yeah, this is the most important thing. 我要对我自己说，
我也要对我们整个教会三个牧区的弟兄姐妹说。
I want to say to myself and I want to say to all three campuses.
后来我在我 Facebook 里面，我加了几个字，反过来也是一样。Amen. 做母亲的，给孩子最好的，就是爱他们的父亲。
And so on my Facebook, I flipped this word around, and it's the same. It's still true that being the most important thing that a mother can do is to love the father for the children to see.
人跟人在一起会有很多的问题。
When people are with people, there's a lot of problems.
但是容许我说，影响人喜欢在一起，最会影响最大的因素就是冲突。
Now, one of the things that influences and affects people that are together.That influences them the most is the influence of conflict.
Dr. John Gottman 是一个研究人啊婚姻关系最深入的一个学者之一。
There's a Dr.
John Gottman.
John Gottman who said this.
他说：“我只要跟一对夫妻坐下来谈15分钟，我就知道他们是不是需要去找一个离婚的律师。” Wow.
After just spending 15 minutes with somebody, I can realize whether they need to go find a marriage counselor or not.
其实所有的夫妻不是没有忍耐，不是没有沟通的技巧，而是不知道怎么解决他们的冲突。
The problem in marriage is not that they don't have patience or they don't have the ability to understand one another, but it's really just the ability to sit down together and resolve a problem.
为什么人跟人会有这么多的冲突？
How come people have so much problems in their
midst? 因为你跟一个与你完全不同的人结婚
，because you are with somebody that's completely different than you.
完全不同的家庭背景的人
，somebody that has a different family background.
所以 ，Pastor Rick Warner 曾经讲过这样的一句话，他说：“婚姻不会解决你的问题，婚姻也不会制造你的问题，婚姻只是把你的问题揭示出来。”
So one time, Pastor Rick Warner said this: "Marriage doesn't solve your problem. Marriage does not create your problem. Marriage reveals your problem."
Do you agree with this? Amen. 婚姻把我们真实的人显明出来。
It reveals who you truly are.
其实不需要 Pastor Rick Warner 这句话，师母已经跟我讲的大概快38年。
We don't need Pastor Rick Warner to have such wisdom. Pastor Becky has already told me this for many, many years.
但是不知道为什么他讲就没有力 Rick Warner 我就把它放在这里。
I don't know why when Pastor Becky tells me, I don't feel like there's a lot of sense in it, but then when Pastor Rick Warner says that, I put it out on my sermon.
所以我告诉你，其实你的配偶比这些牧师更有力量。Hallelujah.
So I'll tell you right now, your spouse has more influence and more power and wisdom than your pastors.
不要去怪别人，反省自己就好了。
Don't be concerned about other people. Just evaluate yourself.
Amen. 直到昨天下午开车，师母还在跟我讲同样的话。
It was only yesterday that we were on the road driving that my wife was telling me the same thing.
你开车的方式就把你的人格给显明出来。
Just the way that you drive is already revealing your problem, who you are.
Are you agree with this?So, 人跟人在一起真的很不简单。
So when people are with others, it's not easy.
好，我要结束了哈。
No, I want to end with this.
但是要怎么能够解决这个问题？我们一起来念，来以弗所书4:26-27，不要因为生气而犯罪，不要到日落的时候怒气未消，不要让魔鬼有机可乘。
Ephesians chapter 4:26. Don't sin by letting anger control you. Don't let the sun go down while you're still angry.
因为人一定要会生气的。
People will get angry. That's no doubt.
Amen. 圣经没有说你不要生气，圣经只有说生气不要犯罪。
The Bible never said don't get angry. The Bible just said when you're angry, don't go sinning.
从某个程度来讲，生气是健康的。
To be honest, it's healthy to be angry at sometimes.
Amen.就好像我们会放屁一样
It's like when we fart.
各位，会放屁是健康的。
To fart is healthy.
Amen. 你不相信啊？
You don't believe me?
只是问题你在什么地方放才是重点呢、啊、
But the question is where do you fart? That's the problem.
Amen. 你到过没有人的地方，空气流通的地方，不影响任何人，对吧
？When you go to an isolated place where there's open air and it's not affecting anybody and you fart, no problem.
但是如果在这里放，它就受影响了。
But if you fart where somebody is next to you and they don't want to smell it, then that person gets influenced by your fart.
圣经没有说你不可以生气。
So the Bible never said do not go get angry.
圣经说你生气的时候不可以犯罪。
But it just said do not get angry and sin.
Amen. 所以各位，对一位丈夫来说，永远不要因为冲突让你的妻子感觉到你不爱她。
So never let your spouse feel that you do not love them.
不要让她感觉到她没有价值，不受尊重。
Never let your spouse feel like they have no value.
我第一个认罪。
And I will be the first to repent.
对一个妻子也是一样，不论你多么生气，永远不要让你的丈夫感觉你看不起他。
And the same goes the other way from husband to wife.
不要让他觉得他不被接受，不被肯定。
Don't let them feel like they're not accepted, they're not acknowledged.
我今天要给各位两个字。
Let me give you two words today.
对姐妹来说需要很多的 affection.
For sisters, they need lots of affection.
Amen. 感谢主，只有 Eno 需要，其他都不需要。
Thank God, only Eno needs the affection. Nobody else needs.
Amen. 但对弟兄来讲
，But for the men,
需要更多的 affirmation.
They need more affirmation.
Amen. 婚姻其实这两个字就够了。
And so, in a marriage, these two words is probably more than enough.
求上帝帮助我们一起来学习。
So may God help us to learn.
最后，对一个做父母的
，Lastly, those that are
不论你的孩子犯的什么错误
，No matter what kind of problems your kids cause,
永远不要让他们感觉他们是不被你看得起、不被接受的。
Don't ever let your kids feel like you do not see them and that they are not accepted by you.
Amen. 当你向你的配偶表示尊荣的时候，还有包括你的孩子，你就是帮助他们。成长成为上帝要他们成为的样子。
When you demonstrate honor to your spouse and to your children, then you are helping to blossom them into what God has called them to be.
什么是叫做 honor?
What is it to be honor?
把价值放在一个人的身上。
It's to value somebody else.
Amen. 用上帝的眼光来看他们。
To use God's eyes to see somebody.
冲突是无可避免。
Conflicts will always be there.
你一定会生气。
You'll always get angry.
但请不要刻意的说出什么样恶毒的话来伤害彼此。
But please do not ever allow yourself to say things that will hurt the other person.
每一对夫妻在一起都是因为起初他们是相爱，渴望生活在一起。
And the reason that couples are together is because they fell in love.
但是因为生活中有很多的冲突的累积
But because of life and many issues
最后就做出或者说出伤害对方的话
In the end they say many things or they do many things that hurt one another
同样的在教会里面也是一样
The same goes for those of us in church
Amen We have to honor for each other
所以我们一定要尊重
不要因为生气而犯罪
Do not sin just because you've been angry.
不要到了日落，怒气还没有消。
And do not let the sun go down and you have not stopped your anger.
因为这个会给魔鬼有机可乘。
Because this will give the devil a foothold in your life.
So we decide together as a family.
一起当一家人。
Amen.
Amen.
在我们的教会里面。我们也可以成为一家的人，好吗
？In our church, we can be one family. Amen.
那我们一起站起来。
Let us stand together.
Praise Jesus. 天父，我感谢你给我们今天早晨这一段的时间。
God, we thank you that we have this amazing time this morning.
谢谢你把我们放在一个属灵的家里面。
We thank you that you've given us a spiritual family.
让我们可以彼此成为弟兄和姐妹。
That we can be brothers and sisters.
主啊，求你把你的爱摆在我们当中。
God, I pray that you would let your love be in our midst.
让我们用你的眼光来对待彼此。
That you would use, that you would give us your perspective to see one another.
主啊，让我们不受这个世界的影响。
Let us not be influenced by the world.
让我们学会彼此的尊重。
But let us learn to honor one another like you do.
主啊，让我们每一个人在这个家里面都被建立起来。
I pray, Father God, that everybody in this family would be raised up.
我奉耶稣基督的名，每一个在神的家里面都要被建立起来。
And I pray that God, every single family in God's house would be raised up.
主，我为 New Life 有这一群可爱的弟兄姐妹来感谢。
I thank you, Lord Jesus, for this beautiful, cute.Group in New Life.
让我们彼此相爱的心能够吸引更多的人来认识你。
That our love for one another would be such an attraction that more people would want to come to know you, Jesus.
祝福我们的每一个家庭。
And we bless every single family here.
祝福我们的每一个孩子们。
And that you would bless all of our kids.
让我们一起在爱中成长。
Let us be one family in love together.
奉耶稣基督得胜的祷告。
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.告诉你旁边的人，我们一起成为家人。
Tell your neighbors, say, let us be a family together.
我们一起成为家人。我们今天的聚会就到这里。愿上帝祝福每一个弟兄姐妹。
Our service will end here today. Be blessed. We love you.
走过去，跟一些弟兄姐妹今天。